Now, your local weather with the KX Storm Team.
It's 5:16. Welcome back on your Monday morning. And Robert, it was a pretty pleasant weekend, I'd have to say.
It was a great weekend overall, mm-hmm. especially yesterday. I mean,
yeah,
absolutely beautiful.
Right.
Not a cloud in the sky. Unfortunately, today, many, many more clouds and colder temperatures.
Okay.
So your stereotypical Monday morning as we take a look outside to the Bismarck SkyCam. You can see off in the distance the visibility is reduced just slightly by a little bit of that fog out there, but I don't expect the fog to be too bad on this Monday morning. As you're waking up this morning in the Bismarck area, you are greeted to a temperature of 17 degrees, which is still about 10 degrees above the average from where we should be this time of the year. Humidity 92%. Meanwhile, in Minot, just slightly warmer, 19 degrees, calm wind, so you don't have to worry about a wind chill as you're headed to the bus stop. In Dickinson, you're also at 19 with 88% humidity, and 21 degrees is your temperature this morning in Williston with a southwest wind at 3 miles an hour. Elsewhere on this Monday morning, temperatures mostly in the upper teens. A few places a little bit warmer. You can see Beach there, 23 degrees. As I said, Williston, 21 degrees. The cool spot this morning, as is the case most days, is Rolla. Up there to the far northeast, you are only at 12 degrees. Because of that fog, National Weather Service has a dense fog advisory. Goes through about 9 a.m. for a handful of counties. It does include Burley County, so Bismarck, you are in it. If you're in one of those counties, your visibilities can be reduced to under a mile or less in certain spots. But again, as we check the visibility map, not really that bad this morning, just a smattering of reduced visibilities. Rugby and Harvey, 7 miles, which still isn't that bad. Mobridge, though, you're at 2 miles, so a little bit thicker fog further to the south. We'll put Precision Cast into motion to talk about the precipitation that's coming this week, or lack thereof. You can see as we go through the day today, just some high clouds, and they'll be thinning out. So I think tomorrow will be mostly sunny, or at least partly sunny, before those clouds fill in as a cold front will slide through on Wednesday. And then after Wednesday, that's when our temperatures will dip. There's some light snow activity here on Thursday, but I don't think that will amount to very much. It's the system that's going to slide by on Friday to the southwest that could bring a few inches of snow to extreme southwestern sections. And this is the storm that's kind of getting the attention, because this storm, as you see up there on your screen, is expected to morph into a major winter storm and affect large portions of the East Coast next weekend, dropping heavy rain and heavy snow. So if your travel plans take you to the east, you want to keep it up to date here on the forecast. Your high today in Bismarck and Dickinson will get to 23 degrees with that morning fog, and then mostly cloudy skies as we go through the day. Meanwhile, in Minot, your forecast will rise to 22 degrees with those morning flurries, otherwise cloudy skies with those south-southeast winds. Highs elsewhere today will range from the mid to lower 20s, warmer to the southwest. Well, they'll get a little bit more sunshine today. You can see Bowman, a forecasted high of 41, but just 18 in Botnose, so quite a spread across the area with those temperatures. Tonight we'll dip to 20 or 15 degrees with those light winds in Bismarck and Dickinson. Meanwhile, in Minot, you will be at 17 degrees with those light winds and comfortable temperatures as well, still above the average for this time of the year. Here's your extended forecast for Bismarck. You can see those morning fog today, and then it'll burn off as we go through the day, and then just some cloudy skies. Windy tomorrow, but you can see those temperatures really dropping off as we go through the week. In fact, most of the upcoming weekend should be spent, unfortunately, right around zero. Same applies for Minot. Dangerous wind chills, I'm worried about Friday night into Saturday with those lows well below zero. So you're going to have to bundle up as we get toward the weekend.
I think many of us could probably go without the colder weather, but I was talking to a few people this weekend. My sister wants more snow. I wouldn't mind a little more snow. My brother-in-law does snow removal. I'm sure he wouldn't mind some. So that was our question of the day for today. And we are just simply asking, do you wish we had more snow? And right now, I figured it would be this way. The vast majority say no. However, look at that. 24% of people out there right now so far this morning say yes, they wish we had a little more snow. So
I love the snow. I love forecasting it. I just don't like driving in it. If we can get a blizzard when I'm off, we can get all we want.
Yeah. It can be fun to drive in the snow.
As long as you're the only car on the road.
Maybe that's a good point.
Yes.
All right. Well, when we return on Good Day Dakota, local YWCA will be under new leadership, but the goal is still the same, and they're still looking for help. We'll have more on that coming up.